Okay, good morning everyone. Yeah, good morning. So today we're going to discuss about the topic that is trigonometric survey. So this trigonometric survey in the online classes also I taught you, but the derivation part I'm going to discuss in this class. Okay, derivation part. So basically this trigonometric survey we're going to do it by using theodolite. Okay, what is the instrument of that? Theodolite. So this theodolite is meant for taking vertical angle and horizontal angle. Okay, so this theodolite we're going to take it by using theodolite we can able to get vertical angle as well as horizontal angle. Okay, so with this help and also by using trigonometry, what we're going to calculate here, we're going to calculate height and distance. Okay, height and distance. Height means the height of the object, and the distance means from the instrument point to the object point. So whatever the distance we're going to cover, so that much of distance. Okay, so that one we're going to have. So start from, so there are, to getting the height and distance, we're going to have three cases. So first case, case number one, if the base of the object is accessible, if the base of the object is accessible, okay. And the case number two, base of the object is inaccessible. Okay. And case number three is also same as case number two. But what is the difference here? So usually for case number one, the figure, if you see the figure, say this is your ground level, okay, and here we're going to keep our theodolite instrument, okay, and say this is your object, okay. So if you see from this point, from the instrument point to the object, we can see the base of this object, right? So it is easily accessible, okay. So this is what it means, first case. Second case, in the second case, so you have the instrument point here, okay, and you have the object here, okay, and here if you see the line of sight, and from this point this base is inaccessible, okay, the base is inaccessible. So this is one case. So suppose if this is your case, then what you're going to do, you're going to have the two instrument points here, okay, two instrument points, so that you can able to have the height. Okay, so further in the when I'm going to explain here in this, so there I will describe how we're going to do that. Okay, so as of now you just think that if the base of the object is inaccessible, at that time you're going to have the two instruments, okay, two instrument points. And for the second case, these two instrument points having the same elevation with respect to vertical plane. Okay, so you can see this, the line of axis is same for the both the instrument point. Okay, and if you're going to point at this point, okay, from this instrument point to top edge of the object height, then you will get one angle, right? So this, here you can say alpha 1 and here you can say alpha 2. Okay, say this instrument point is P and say R. Okay, don't write down all this. So later I will send you this, all these things. Okay, I think I already forwarded it to you, right? So this trigonometrical leveling. So from P, whatever the angle you're going to have, okay, so that you just denote alpha 2, and from R, whatever the angle you're going to have, you just denote alpha 1. So like this, so this instrument having same elevation, okay, same elevation with respect to the vertical plane, okay. So this is having instrument axis, axis same, okay, same in vertical plane. Okay, in vertical plane. So this is which is coming under second case. In the third case, again you will have the same thing, that is base of the object is inaccessible. So here the instrument axis of the instrument will be different. Okay, instrument axis different in vertical plane. So here if you see the instrument P that is slightly higher than instrument R, okay, the axis. So here also you will have the same angle, say angle is alpha 2, okay, alpha 2. So there will be difference in instrument axis, okay. So these are the three cases you're going to have. So now we'll go one by one. So I will take first case. Is there any doubt? No. What is the first case? If the base of the object is accessible. If the base of the object is accessible, then you just take a figure. Say this is your ground profile. And here, so as concerned with the leveling, so starting whatever the point we're going to start with. With what? With what? With what? Yes, you're right. What is this? Bench mark. Okay. So that will be the reference point, right? So you will start always, whenever you do the leveling, so you always start with the benchmark. Okay. So this, on this benchmark, you're going to keep what? What? Not report. Leveling stuff. Okay. Leveling stuff. So here, you're going to keep third leg. Okay. And say this is your instrument point. This is your object. This is your object. Okay. And say this is your line of axis, or you can say line of sight. Okay. Axis. And if you see line of axis with respect to the benchmark, so this will give, say I'm going to denote S. S is nothing but what? Staff reading. Okay. What is S? Staff reading. Okay. Staff reading. Okay. Now, and from here, from the axis, line of axis, to the top edge, I'm going to denote H. Okay, H. And this point, top edge of the object, I'm going to denote Q. Okay, and the instrument point, I'm going to denote P. The line of sight of the object, I'm going to denote A. Okay, and from this line of sight, with respect to this, from the third leg, whatever the angle we're going to take to bisecting at Q, top edge of the object. So this angle I'm going to denote alpha. Okay. And the distance from instrument point to the object point, I'm going to denote D. Okay. D. D is nothing but what? The distance between instrument point to the object. Okay. So is there any doubt? No doubt? Okay. Our main motto is what? To calculate distance and height. Okay. Distance and height. So this will be the distance, that will be the height. Okay. Now, you just consider triangle A and this line of sight where it is coinciding to the object. So this point I am going to denote Q dash. Okay, Q dash. So the triangle will be what? A, Q dash, Q. Okay, so this will be your triangle. So for this triangle, so it's a right angle triangle, right? It's a right angle triangle. Now for getting the height, opposite height, h is equal to what? You know the distance? Right, you know the alpha. So h is equal to d into tan alpha. Is it or not? Yes. What is tan alpha? Opposite by adjacent. Right, opposite by adjacent. Where opposite is h, adjacent is d. Where h is equal to d into tan alpha. Now you got it? Okay. So you got this value h. Okay, now we need to calculate RL here. Okay, RL. So wherever you go, if you are getting the leveling, wherever we're going to use this term leveling, so there we have to find RLs. Okay, RL. So here in this case, if you are going to calculate RL of Q, then what are you going to have? RL of Q. First, you're going to say RL of benchmark. Okay, so RL of benchmark plus staff reading. Is it or not? Yes. Plus from here to there, that is H. So write H. Okay. So if you again simplify this, RL of benchmark plus S plus H we have already, that is D tan alpha. So this is the final equation for RL of Q. So is it simple? So basically here they may give you RL of benchmark, or else directly they will give you RL of instrument axis. Okay. If suppose RL of instrument axis is given, then what will be the RL of Q? Anybody can tell me? If instrument axis is given, okay. So I will write if instrument access is given, if RL of instrument access is given, then RL of Q, can anybody tell? RL of Q will be? RL of Q will be? RL of instrument access plus H. Yes? That's it. So you are getting RL up to this level, instrument access. Then you just add height. Okay, that height we know. What is that? D into tan alpha. Substitute that and get the height. Is that simple? Any doubt? No doubt? Shall I rub? Okay. So this is the case one. So this notes I already forwarded in the group. Okay, you just refer that. Which one? Yeah, suppose benchmark is not given in the question, okay, directly they given instrument RL, then you just add that instrument RL and directly calculate that one, okay, or else they're going to give the benchmark as well as the staff reading, okay, benchmark plus staff reading, you will get the instrument access, RL of instrument access, are you getting my point? So to getting this instrument access, RL, RL of instrument access, so that will be what, benchmark plus staff reading. Okay. So this benchmark won't be direct, simply benchmark. It will be RL of benchmark plus staff reading. So that will give RL of instrument access. Okay. So in the question, if they go give, going to give this direct RL of instrument access, then you just substitute RL of instrument access plus H. Okay. That's all. Next, coming to the second case, what is that? Inaccessible. If the base of the object is inaccessible, so there we are just putting one condition, what is that? Instrument access having same level in the vertical plane. So this is the case. Okay, now here we're going to have the ground profile like this, okay, and this is the ground level. So here we're going to keep our theodolite. So two points we're going to have the instrument, right? So one point and this one is the second point, so which is having the same level, we are having the same level, and here this is your benchmark, okay, benchmark, and this will be your what? Staff reading, okay, staff reading, and here we are just keeping what? Object. So this may be a building or anything, okay. Now this point I'm going to denote Q, and this axis from this height to this line of sight, so this I'm going to denote H, okay, H, and this point I'm going to say Q dash, okay, Q dash. And the angle, so these points are instrument points, so this I'm going to denote R, and this one is P, PRQ, okay, PRQ. And from here, whatever this height you're going to have towards Q, so whatever the angle you're going to form with the reference of A, instrument A, so that will become your alpha 1, okay, alpha 1. And from here, from B towards Q, so the angle which is going to form, that will be alpha 2, okay? And the distance between two instrument point, say small b. And from instrument point P to the object, say this one is D, okay, D. And as you know, this is staff reading. Yeah, that's all. So now we'll solve, what will be the RL? What will be the equation for RL at Q? Okay, RL at Q. So starting from, we'll take the triangle. So triangle A, Q, Q dash, A, Q, Q dash, okay, A, Q, Q dash. So here, to getting the H, what is the equation? D into, tan alpha 1, right? Okay. say this equation number 1. Next triangle B Q Q dash. So this one say H, because you're having the same elevation, so H won't be differ. So same H we're going to carry. So H is equal to B plus D into tan alpha 2. Say this equation number 2. So equation number 1 and equation number 2 both having H same, right? So that we're going to equate equation number 1 and equation number 2. Okay. So equating equation 1 and 2. So D tan alpha 1 is equal to B plus D tan alpha 2. Okay. So here what we want, D we want. Okay. So D, to getting the D, what we're going to do? So here again I'm going to simplify. D tan alpha 1. So B tan alpha 2 plus D tan alpha 2. So here this D tan alpha 2 I'm taking in the left hand side. So D tan alpha 1 minus D tan alpha 2 is equal to B tan alpha 2. Okay. Now T, you just take it common. So D into tan alpha 1 minus tan alpha 2 is equal to D tan alpha 2. Okay. Next you calculate. D is equal to, what will be the equation? B tan alpha 2 divided by, yes, tan alpha 1 minus tan alpha 2. Okay. All right. Now say this equation number 3. Okay. Substitute this equation number 3 in equation number 1. Okay. So substituting equation 3 in equation 1. So H is equal to, where D we already have, that is B tan alpha 2 divided by tan alpha 1 minus tan alpha 2 into tan alpha 1. So this will be the equation. Okay. So this is height. So this will become your distance. Right. What is our main motor now? We need to get RL. So RL at Q, or RL of Q is equal to, tell me, RL of benchmark, okay, RL of benchmark plus H, then RL of benchmark plus S plus H, we already have the equation, substitute that. That is B tan alpha 2 tan alpha 1 divided by tan alpha 1 minus tan alpha 2. Okay. So is it simple? Yeah. That's all for the case number 2. Okay, case number 2. So we'll go for case number 3 now. Which one? Instrument pointer. Because see, the base here, base is inaccessible. Okay. So where, if it is accessible, only from one reading you can able to calculate, right? If base is inaccessible, so you're supposed to keep two instrument points here. Okay. You can keep it three also. That is not a big deal. But having the two points only, you can able to have the RL of the instrument, of the object. Okay. Yeah, you just take it. If you're having only one, okay, only one, so there will be only one equation. Okay, there will be only one equation. With that equation, we can't able to have distance and height. Is it or not? Yes, two variables, two unknowns. Yes, two variables, two unknowns. Means two unknowns we have here, that is H and D. Which one? Yeah, more than two also you can take it, no problem. More than two also you can take it. You just take third point also. Okay. You just compare with third point and first point. First point with second point. So like that. You can jumble it. So basically only two is enough. Okay. Two is enough. You can go for 3, 4, 5 like that. N number you can take it. But only two you're going to choose while getting this D and H. Okay. Is that clear? So that's the reason we are taking the two instrument points. Now next, for the third case. What is the third case? If the instrument axis having different level, okay, instrument axis having different level. So is it clear, this concept? Yeah. So this is same. So I'm just writing here different level, okay, in the vertical plane, in the third case. So this is case number three. Case number three. So we're going to keep again the profile of the ground somewhat same. And here we're going to have our object. Say this top edge of the object Q. And here we're going to have the object, instrument, that is P. And the second instrument point, somewhat what I'm going to do, I will keep more height compared to the P instrument. Say this is R. So this is your instrument point. Now, so this will be your line of axis at P instrument. At R instrument, this will be your line of axis. Okay. And if you see back one, so always we're going to start with the reference point, that is benchmark. On this benchmark, we're going to keep leveling staff. Okay, leveling staff. So if you see at the leveling staff, so whatever the readings you're going to have, okay, for this axis, two axis, which is having different axis, right? So this axis, say this one is S1, and this one is, say, S2. Okay, S1 and S2. And whatever the difference between these two, say this one is small s, okay? So difference between two instrument axes on the leveling staff, so that I'm going to denote, yes, small s, okay, small s, okay? Now, here also you're going to have two heights now, because there will be two axes, so two heights. So this axis, the bottom one, from here to here, I will tell H1, okay? And from here to here, H2, okay? And difference in H1 minus H2, so what are you going to have? What are we going to have? Yes, is it or not? Same axis. So difference between H1 minus H2, you will get yes only, right? Yeah. So what, again, with the help of the theodolite, we're going to bisect this point Q and say this instrument point of the axis, that is A, and this one is B. From A towards Q, you're going to sight, and you're just going to get the alpha 1. From B to Q, and get the alpha 2. Okay, alpha 2, yeah. And the distance between these two instrument point, what we're going to denote? D. And the distance between P instrument point to the object, we're going to say D, okay? D. And as you know, this is ground. Is there any doubt to understanding this figure? Yes. This one, huh? Suppose, yeah, good question. Why I am taking different elevation, right? Different elevation. So there will be a chances, not chances, maximum chances of getting difference in the elevation of the instrument. We can't set our instrument having the same elevation. Do we keep? Because ground will be, doesn't have the proper level. So there will be undulated, ground will be undulated somewhat. So due to that reason, there will be a chances of having this kind of difference in level of the instrument axis, okay? So that is one reason, okay? That is one reason. Sir has taught only the same level means you have to keep same level. So you can do that, but that proximity you won't have. Okay? Which one? Yeah, case two I kept same level, but case three is different level. Okay? So those are the cases you're going to have it on the feet. Okay? All the cases won't be same. Case one is different, accessible. Case two is inaccessible, having same elevation. And case three is different elevation. Okay? So shall we proceed? Yeah. So first I'm going to take the triangle. So before taking the triangle, so I want to denote this axis, okay, line of axis. So where it's going to hit the instrument, object. That is, say this is Q, say this is Q dash, and say this is Q1. Okay, Q dash, Q1. Now I will take for the instrument P, okay, for the instrument P, taking the triangle, A, Q1, Q, okay? Now, to getting the height, so height is H1. So H1 is equal to? D into tan alpha 1, okay? So say this is equation number 1. Second, you take triangle B, Q dash Q. So this will be H2, right? H2. So H2 is equal to? D plus D tan alpha 2, right? Any other thing? Yes, sir. Is there anything? Nothing. Yeah. Now here, in the previous case, what we have done? We have just equated equation number 1 and equation number 2. But in the previous case, it was same level, right? The instrument level was same and even the H was same. But here, H is different. So what we are going to do? We are going to subtract equation number 1 and equation number 2. Okay? Subtract equation number 1 and equation number 2. Okay? So H1 minus H2 is equal to first H1 minus H2 is equal to
yes, okay.
Yes. Now you just substitute the equation. So H, that is D tan alpha 1 minus B plus D tan alpha 2. Okay. Now you just simplify. You take only this S. Okay. Don't take this H1 minus H2. So I'm just taking S now. So S is equal to D tan alpha 1 minus B alpha 2 minus D tan alpha 2. Okay. Now you take this 2, D common. So D into tan alpha 1 minus tan alpha 2 minus B tan alpha 2. Yes. Sorry. Next, you take the B1, D direct. Okay. So I'm just writing D now. Okay. So D is equal to S plus B tan alpha 2 divided by, yes, good, tan alpha 1 minus tan alpha 2. Okay. So this will be the equation for D. Okay. Distance. And say this is equation number 3. So if you are getting the equation number 3, directly equation number 3, substitute that in equation number 1. Okay. So substituting equation number 3 in equation number 1. Okay. Equation number 1. So H1 is equal to S plus, so I'm writing direct D, okay, S plus B tan alpha 2 divided by tan alpha 1 minus tan alpha 2 into, what is that? Tan alpha 1. Okay, tan alpha 1. So this is the equation, okay, for getting the H1. Now you tell me, if I know this H1, can you able to have RL at Q? H1 and D? Right? Can you able to have? Yes? Then you tell me, for to getting RL of Q is equal to, first RL of benchmark, yes, correct, RL of benchmark plus S1 or S2? S1 or S2? S1 related to this instrument. Which one? S1, huh? Yes. S1, okay, plus H1. Right? S1 and H1, plus H1. So we will get the RL of Q. Okay? So similarly, you write, you substitute this formula here, okay, in the equation. That's all. So H1, whatever you got here, same thing you substitute there. So is it simple? Okay. So like that, you have another also, differential level. If B axis having less height compared to A axis, okay, for that also you need to find. Okay. So there also you will have the same thing. Instead of plus, you will get minus here. So you just go through it, okay. So will you do that? Is it simple? So same thing you have to do. Get the equation number 1, equation number 2, and get the difference of that, okay. And simplify and get H1 and substitute that H1 in this form. Okay. Yeah. So we'll solve one problem now. So, right, problem number 1. An instrument, an instrument was set up at P, and the angle of elevation, to A vane 4 meter. So there is a vane 4 meter having above the foot of the staff held at Q was 9 degree 30 minute. The horizontal distance between P and Q was known to be 2000 meters. Determine the RL of the staff, station Q. Given that the RL of the instrument axis was 2650.38 meters. See here, RL of the instrument axis is given directly, that is 2650.38. So here, one thing you have to understand, suppose say this is your instrument, so this is your line of sight, okay? So above the line of sight, whatever the angle you're going to have, okay? Above the line of sight, means line of axis, whatever the angle you're going to have, so this angle is going to be your angle of elevation. What is that? Angle of elevation. And whatever the line of axis which is taking below, vertical angle, so that is going to be your angle of depression, okay? Angle of depression. Right? So angle of elevation, angle of depression. So in this case, is it angle of depression or angle of elevation? So here you have to understand. So this is angle of elevation. Okay, angle of elevation. So basically, this theodolite survey, you consider wherever we're going to go for geodetic survey. So in the principles of survey, there are two surveys we're going to have. What are those? One is geodetic survey and another one is plane survey. Right? So in the geodetic survey, we're going to consider the curvature of the earth. And whereas in the plane survey, we are neglect the curvature of the earth. Okay? So that is the difference. So here, what we're going to do, first, we're going to calculate the curvature and the refraction of the ground. Okay? Curvature and refraction of the ground. So here we're going to have the correction here. So directly I'm just writing correction for curvature and refraction. That is equal to 0. So directly I'm putting the formula. Okay. So this formula you have to keep it in your mind always. 0.6728 d² Okay, d square. Where d is the distance between the instrument point to the object. Okay. And here always you have to keep it that in your mind. That is d is going to be in kilometer. Okay. Suppose in the question if they're going to give you in meters, that you have to convert into kilometers. Okay. So now we'll convert that, okay? 0.0678 into D is, what is D? How much? 4 meter, huh? The horizontal distance between P and Q was known to be 2000 meters, okay? So 2000 divided by 1000. Why I'm taking this divided by 1000? Because I'm converting that into kilometer, okay? So convert that in kilometer and just make it square. Okay, how much you're going to have? 0.269 something you will have. Okay, so I'm just going to write 0.27. So 0.27. So this value, the unit will be meter. Okay, don't consider that in kilometer. Okay, so that is the thing what I wanted to explain here. So here in the refraction only, we just converted and we just making in terms of kilometer, and the final result will be in meters. Okay, that will be in meters. So 0.27 meters. Okay, which one? So that is what I am telling you. This curvature. So this formula, I am directly putting this. Okay, this curvature, I am putting the direct formula. For this, the another will be there. Means I need to describe that. So as concerned with the what the subject. Okay, as per the syllabus. So I am just making very short. Okay, I am just making very short. So this curvature and refraction, you just have this formula.
Standard formula.
Okay, have the standard formula. So this d convert into kilometer. After converting that, you substitute all the value and simplify, and the final value will be in meters. Okay, is that clear? Okay. Now next, height of the vane above the instrument axis. Instrument axis. Okay, height of the vane above instrument axis. Say h is equal to. Say this is your profile. This is your profile and this is your instrument. So this is your vane. Okay. So this vane having 4 meter. Okay. This vane having 4 meter. So this is your object. So this is your Q point. Okay. Q point. And here you are keeping theodolite. And whatever the axis you're going to have. So this will be your angle. So angle is alpha. Alpha is given how much? 9 degrees 30 minutes. Okay. So what you need to find here? You need to find RL of Q. Okay, RL of Q. So before that, first we'll calculate what will be the h from this end to this one. Okay, h is equal to d tan alpha. So where d is 2000, right? 2000. Tan alpha is 9 degrees 30 minutes. So is equal to, so how much you're going to have? 334.68 meters. Okay, 334.68 meters. So after having that, next what we do, so whatever the corrections is there, so this correction, I told you, if the angle, if it is getting elevation, then you just add it. Okay, add this to this one. If the angle is getting depression, then you just put minus. Okay, put minus. So what I'm going to do, so I'm going to add. So height of vane above the instrument axis, that is 334.68 plus 0.27. okay, so you will get how much? 334.95 meters. So after having this, next what we do, RL of vane. So I'm just getting direct RL of vane. So RL of vane is equal to, what is that? Instrument axis is given directly, right? RL of instrument axis plus h we already calculated, right? So this will become your new h. Okay, after adding the correction. So RL of the instrument axis, that is how much? 2650.38 plus 334.95. so is equal to 2985.33 meters. okay, so this much you're going to have. So RL of vane. Our main motto is what? You need to determine RL of this staff station. Okay, given. So staff station given, so that will become your object, staff. Okay, that will become your object. So RL of Q is equal to, tell me, RL of vane minus 4. Yes, if you see this figure, RL of Q, so RL of vane minus 4, you will get RL of Q. So how much you going to have? 2985.33 minus 4 is equal to 2981.33 meter. Okay, so is it simple? Any doubt here? No doubt. Yeah, that's all for today's class. So in the next class, I will discuss about the omitted measurements. Okay, omitted measurements, which is related to latitude and departures. Okay, so that I will discuss in the next class.